Everybody, and welcome to this week's On the Horizon. We have some great news for you this week, whether you're interested in flying, driving, boating, cool power plants, and a whole lot more. So let's get started. And we are going to get started this week with two new models from ProBoat. They have two new 17-inch boats, such as this one here. This is a 17-inch Miss Geico ready to run. There's also a 17-inch Impulse ready to run too. These are great boats. As you can see, nice size on here that you can run in a number of different areas. Decent speed, completely ready to run, includes your battery pack, battery charger, even includes a 2.4 gigahertz transmitter and receiver for you too. We caught up with Kevin Hedmensky. Yes, that Kevin Hedmensky. He is the newest member of the Horizon Hobby family, and he is our new ProBoat product developer. We caught up with Kevin to learn about the new 17-inch Miss Geico and the 17-inch Impulse.
Hi, I'm Kevin Hedmensky, product developer for ProBoat, and I want to show you our new 17-inch boats that we have available. You can get two different hulls when you're choosing your boat. One is a deep V hull like our Impulse here, or you can get an officially licensed Miss Geico catamaran. Now both hulls have similar drivetrains and electronics, so I'm going to go ahead and use this as our guide. Now in the back of the boat you're going to find a molded plastic rudder which features a breakaway design, so if you happen to hit something in the water, the rudder is going to flip up, protect the hull and protect the rudder from damage. And then you also have a molded plastic prop. Now the canopy is held in place by a magnet, so all you have to do is just put your canopy down and the magnet holds it in place while you're in the water. No need for tape or a latch. Now on the inside you're going to find a 380 size motor to propel this boat, and it's got water cooling to keep the temperatures down while you're driving it. And it's also on an adjustable motor mount, so you can make some tweaks here and there if you have to straighten that motor out. Now also in the back here you're going to find an ESC receiver combo, which is actually going to save a lot of room compared to a separate ESC and separate receiver. And you have a micro servo. Now let's take a look at the radio. To control the boats, you get a 2.4 gigahertz radio system in the box. And one of the things I like about this radio is an antenna that's really short. It doesn't flex and it doesn't bend, so you don't really have to worry about breaking it. It's also packed full of features that you don't find on other ready-to-run radios, such as steering and throttle trim, steering and throttle reverse, and steering and throttle dual rate. Some of the buttons are also protected here under this little cover, and you'll find the on-off switch there. Another nice feature is that it's powered by four AA batteries. All right, guys, well, that's a quick look at our new 17-inch boats. If you'd like more information, go to our website, ProBoatModels.com. And don't forget to go on Facebook and like the ProBoat Facebook page.
Thanks a lot, Kevin. Now, one thing of note, too, is the Impulse actually comes out of the box completely white, just like this. And right in the box, it also includes three sets of decals, as you guys saw in some of the footage that we had there. There's a red decal sheet, a purple, and then you also have a green. So you can really go ahead and make your boat your own, depending on how you want it to go ahead and look. In addition, this week we have two new big cars coming to you from ECX, and these are the Revenge Type E and the Revenge Type N. That's right, 1/8 scale buggies from the world of ECX. You know it's going to have great performance and awesome durability without breaking the bank. Par for the course with all ECX models. We caught up with Derek Wagner with ECX to find out more about the new Revenge Type E and Type N.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Gary. I got to tell you, gang, I'm excited to be here today. What we have in front of you today is unlike anything we've ever brought to you from the ECX RC brand. We have an 8-scale platform available in brushless electric or nitro. So let's dive right into the vehicles. On the right here, on your left, you have the ECX 8-scale Type E brushless 4-wheel drive buggy. The buggy comes fully loaded with Dynamite electronics, including a Dynamite 2500 kV brushless 550 size motor, 130 amp ESC that's 2S to 4S LiPo compatible. So if you're a brand new RC enthusiast and you're just getting into the hobby and you grab an 8-scale vehicle, you might just want to pop in a 2S LiPo battery. It's going to give you 25-27 miles per hour out of the box, which is extremely quick for an 8-scale vehicle, especially for a newbie. That's also going to give you a time to get sort of accustomed to the vehicle. You can drive around the neighborhood, take it to the track if you like, and then you can move up to 3S or 4S when you get more comfortable with the vehicle. The vehicle also comes loaded with Dynamite Speed Treads Watchdog tires. It's going to provide just relentless grip on the track, in the cul-de-sac, in your driveway, in your yard. The vehicle just performs really well. It has four-wheel drive, shaft-driven platform, adjustable turnbuckles. Really everything you would find, just about everything you would find in an 8-scale platform to make it not only track ready, but it's really basher friendly. I've driven this vehicle personally, and I can tell you this is some of the most durable vehicles I've driven. It's really been beefed up to handle the abuse that a lot of the bashers on our market today put these vehicles through. Let's talk about a few more details, because I think I've left out some of the more important aspects of the vehicle. It includes a Spectrum DX2E 2.4 GHz radio system. So it comes fully loaded with Dynamite electronics, Spectrum 2.4. It even includes a Dynamite waterproof servo. So yes, the vehicle is waterproof. Something you've been asking us for from ECX for quite some time. Now it's here. We could talk for hours about the Type E. Look at the body. It looks outstanding. Our content or our graphics team did an excellent job designing the body. It really speaks to the high impact visuals that we requested, and really actually speaks to you guys, our target audience. Let's shift directions here and talk about the Type N. This is completely new for ECX RC. This is a nitro buggy. We've gotten a lot of requests from our consumers, from our retail partners. You know, a lot of consumers get into the hobby with their first vehicle being a nitro vehicle, and we wanted to provide those consumers with a value-oriented but extremely durable and fun 8-scale vehicle. So here we have the Type N. Just like the Type E, it comes fully loaded with Dynamite. It comes with a Dynamite waterproof servo. It comes with a Dynamite 21 size Sport Mach 2 engine with pole start, so it's extremely versatile, extremely rugged. It's going to start on the first pole just about every time. It comes preloaded from the factory with just about everything you need except for four AA's to power the receiver. Similar to the Type E, it has Speed Treads Watchdog tires. It has adjustable turnbuckles, oil-filled shocks, the Spectrum 2.4 GHz radio system, pre-painted body. It has that. You know, one thing I want to mention is both vehicles come with the three diff setup with already grease filled. But if you want to get a little bit more versatile and fine tune the performance, you can always fill it with oil, of course. But for bashers, out of the box, these things are an absolute blast. Again, you know, with ECX, we want to make sure that we're providing consumers and you guys with the ultimate vehicles when it comes to value, fun, and durability. And I'm excited to see us to move into the 8-scale market. I think our consumers are just going to go crazy over these vehicles. They're fast, they're durable, and they just look awesome. Let's talk about what's needed to complete the vehicles, because these are the first vehicles in the ECX brand that don't come completely ready to run, meaning they don't come with, the Type E does not come with a battery. Obviously the Type N does not come with fuel. So let's just talk about briefly what you're going to need to make these vehicles go. So for the Type E, you're going to need 1, 2 to 3S LiPo battery, or 2 2S LiPo batteries if you want to go all out 4S. The ESC comes pre-wired with a high current EC3 connector, so your batteries are going to need to have that connector. If they don't, you're going to need to get an adapter. You're going to need to solder a new connector on there, or buy a Dynamite Speedpack battery with the EC3 connector pre-installed. You're going to need a LiPo charger for those batteries, the new DYN4108, the Dynamite Profit Sport Duo. Great charger for this application. It's going to charge your batteries fast. You can charge two at a time, and you'll be ready to rock. Four AA batteries for the transmitter, and that's all. For the Type N, you're going to need four AA's to power the receiver, or you can upgrade to a Dynamite receiver pack if you want a little bit more power and reliability. Also, you're going to need Blue Thunder fuel. Any fuel of your choice will work, but we recommend Blue Thunder, of course, from Dynamite. 20% sport fuel will do the job just fine. I put it in this bad boy, fired up on the first start, it ran great. So those are the completion items you are going to need. Again, it's a first for ECX, but I think with the 8-scale market, it's pretty typical that the 8-scale vehicles don't come with everything needed. That way you can customize the performance to your liking. Anyway, grab one of these when they hit the shops. I think you're going to love it. Get us on Facebook, Twitter. Tell us what you think. We love to hear from you. Thank you.
Man, these new ECX buggies look awesome. Brushless, 2.4 gigahertz, a 21 size engine, and a whole lot more. These are going to be some great ways to get involved in the world of 1/8 scale buggy racing and just bashing if you're looking to do so on a budget. Along with everything that Derek went over on both vehicles, there's also a couple other things just to let you know about. First of all, they both come with aluminum bodied, oil filled shocks, so you don't have plastic shocks that'll expand and you'll have piston blow by as the piston goes up and down through its range of motion. You also have metal front and rear shock towers and adjustable servo saver, metal knuckles on here. It just, there's a lot that have gone into these cars to really make them an exceptional experience for you to get your start in. Talking about exceptional experiences, we had an exceptional experience this week with Bob Novak, Linda Novak, and Charlie Swanka. These guys came out to Horizon Hobby all the way from California and Novak Electronics, and they shared some information with us on some of their newest products. And you can see we have some of them here for you right on the bench, from their vented high RPM motors, the Pulse speed controller, the Activate speed controller, and a whole lot more. We had a chance to catch up with Charlie Swanka from Novak Electronics to get the lowdown on this new cool technology coming to you from Novak Electronics.
All right, thanks a lot, Gary. I guess first and foremost, the one that everybody's the most excited about is our Activate SCT system. We do the Activate with our 4.5 turn 550 motor that has the vented end bells on it already. This system is the do-all, answer-all for your short course racing needs. A lot of you guys in your short courses are a little rough on the trigger, if you will, and that's what this guy's for. If you think you need the biggest, most robust speed control for your short course, come check out the Activate combos. We also do the Activate in a combo with our A-scale motors as well, the 1.5 and the 2.0 motors. Those are for all your A-scale racing needs, of course. Something I'm pretty excited about that we're coming up with is a new speed control called the Pulse. The Pulse looks much like our Havoc Pro SC, and because it shares a lot of the same roots. What's different about it is we've addressed it with a 5 amp BEC now. The standard Havoc Pro SC and most of the other speed controls out there have a 3 amp or lower rated BEC. A lot of the servos that are starting to come around these days are drawing much more power than 3 amps, so the Pulse is the first speed control to address that problem. We put in the next size up regulator. We've had very good luck with this regulator and other products of ours, and we know for a fact that this should hold up much better. The Pulse also features a new power capacitor that helps address the new higher speeds that we've been seeing. It helps protect the speed control, help protect the batteries from these voltage spikes, and we also have installed high quality 12 gauge wire on the speed control now as well. And something that's my favorite feature, see that?
It's got an orange case.
That's right. So the Pulse will be the new heavy-duty two-cell racing speed control. So for all you short course guys, all you modified racers, touring car guys, the speedrun guys, the Pulse has our newest version of Super Tuner, which features all the adjustable parameters from the impact, as well as extra timing. We have normal dynamic timing that applies to the normal range of RPM and you use for average usages, but for like the speedrun stuff or you high-end spec raters, extra timing is what most people call boost from our Kinetic Days. So extra timing is back now, but it's not the same that it was. We've addressed all of the shortcomings of the boost. We've put in some more protocols for what the speed control is monitoring while this is happening, and the speeds are ridiculous. The guys that we have testing this on the on-road side cannot believe how fast these speed controls are, and they're extremely excited to get these to market. So keep an eye out for the Pulse. That'll be out pretty quick here, probably in the next couple weeks. Next up is a speed control that just started shipping, the Impact. Now the Impact is a little guy. See that? How small that is? It's smaller than my hand. The Impact is suited for all of the medium duty applications, or it's a small heavy duty speed control. One of the things that I run into with a lot of the other products that are out there, they make these little speed controls that you can't use for anything. Well, this speed control is suited for modified racing. It has our Super Tuner firmware in it, it has our dynamic timing advance, and It has our new higher profile speed or heat sink for those. It's a cross cut heat sink that is a full coverage unit that covers all of the drive components of the speed control. The impact is suited for all of the two wheel drive applications, two wheel drive buggy, two wheel drive truck, or any of the spec racing setups. You can use it in VTA, spec touring car racing, obviously spec four wheel drive racing, anything that you need a smaller, lightweight speed control in, and you're not so hard on the BEC or the servo demands. This unit has the 2-amp BEC in it, but it also comes with everything that the racer needs. We include our glitch buster with all of our race products so that if your servo is a little bit much, that you get a little help there. Next up in our lineup here is the high RPM spec motors. Novak has been a staple of spec motor racing for a very long time without being motor of the month club. We've had the same basic motor for many years now. So in order to bring our dedicated racers something new and maybe a little bit faster, we've introduced the high RPM stators, and we also sell these as a high RPM complete motor. So what sets these apart from the standard ballistic motor? Well, one, the standard ballistic motor doesn't come with the vented end bells. Our premium motors do. These come with the vented end bells as well, and it comes with a slightly different red wire stator. These stators have been shaped a little bit differently to give us a little more RPM. And basically, the simple answer here, folks, is these spec motors are faster than our previous spec motors. So if you're going out club racing or you're going out spec racing, look for the new high RPM ballistic motors from Novak. So let's talk about the combos that we're going to have for everybody now. Everybody loves cost savings, and Novak does a fantastic job of saving you hard-earned money with our combo systems. Buy a speed control, get a motor for almost half price, I think. So you're looking at three different combos in the pulse system. We have a pulse with a 17.5, we have a pulse with a 6.5, and we also do a pulse with a 4.5 550 motor for all you short course enthusiasts out there. So the impact we do in two combos as well. We do a 7.5 and a 17.5 combo for all the spec racers out there. And our Active 8 comes in three combos. We do the Active 8 with both of the A-scale motors and our new vented 4.5 550 motor for the short course guys. Some of the new topics that we've come up with here at Novak have been X-Drive and Super Tuner. X-Drive has been a game changer for everybody here at Novak. It's been night and day for how the speed control feels. That intangible thing that none of the racers know how to talk about correctly is feel. X-Drive gives that very natural, very organic feel. You get tons of rip that's extremely smooth. It seems really strange to say it has punch and smooth at the same time, but that's the magic behind X-Drive. It gives you tons of power that's extremely easy to control. Next up is Super Tuner. Super Tuner is going to be the save-all for you racers out there. Nobody likes to have a programming device that they have to worry about. I can't find my programmer, my laptop won't turn on, I don't want to bring my laptop to the dirty track. Super Tuner gets rid of the need for all of that. Super Tuner starts with five completely savable and customizable profiles. You can set five unique or five very similar profiles into the speed control at your own leisure. We also put five predefined defaults in there so that you can select from the Novak settings if you like. And what that allows you to do is change between genres very easily. We have non-timing for low traction, non-timing for high traction, mild timing applications, aggressive timing applications, and then we have the speed run applications at the end. These core profiles will get you in the ballpark so that you don't have to make drastic changes to the profiles. You can just make fine-tuning adjustments. This complete and total all-encompassing onboard programming means one thing. You are a self-supporting racer. You don't need anybody's help to tune your speed control. You can do it all right on board. The new LED sequences and the new order of the settings make it extremely intuitive and easy for you as a racer to remember what you want to adjust. We actually group the settings together and we separate them by the number of lights that we use. All the drive settings are together, all the timing settings are together, all the brake settings together, and then all the other fun stuff that we never use is way down there at the end. I can do all of that and still have a speed control that has RPM tables so that for you timing advanced racers that are out there, the speed controls have every table or every RPM range that you're going to need, and we do that with a very simple table system. The speed controls have multiple tables that have different RPM ranges, start and finish RPMs. Each of those tables are suited for a different type of racing. We have one cell racing, spec racing with two cell, and we have modified tables as well that vary in the adjustability or the fine tuning of the steps. It all comes in a very easy to read manual, and we give you a shortcut sticker that goes right on your transmitter so that when you want to make trackside changes because the condition change, you can do that right from the driver's hand. You walk down, pick up your car, make the changes, throw it back down, and away you go. No running around looking for a programmer, no waiting for the next session. You can do it while you're on the track and you're in your rhythm, feel what the speed control is really doing for you. Super Tuner is going to be the next best thing that came to RC racing. So, thanks for joining us, everybody. My name is Charlie Sawanka from Novak Electronics. You can check out everything at www.teamnovak.com.
Again, just want to thank Bob Novak, Linda Novak, and Charlie Sawanka for giving us their time and sharing some of the really cool information with you about the new gear that is coming and shipping from Novak Electronics. Speaking about cool gear that's shipping, we have some exciting news on three models that you guys on the air side have really been waiting for. First of all, the Blade Nano CPX, both the RTF and the Bind and Fly, have started to ship. You'll be able to find those at your local hobby shops and available through horizonhobby.com. Now, one of the things with both the Ready to Fly and Bind and Fly is there are reasons why we do pre-orders on these models, and you may find one a little bit harder to get than the other. That's something you should always remember whenever we announce a new product. Go ahead, pre-order it. That way, you make sure that you get one out of one of the first batches. That way, you kind of reduce your wait time a little bit too. We also have information on the new Park Zone Corsair, the big park flyer one. That is now also shipping, and you'll be able to get some fun flying outdoors before the snow flies with that new beautiful Corsair. I kind of like the little drop tank that's on there and everything. It's a really pretty, pretty plane. Make sure you keep an eye on horizonhobby.com and your local participating hobby shop for more information on the latest gear and when you can expect to see it really soon. Now it's time for this week's Tip from the Workbench. This week's tip from the workbench comes again to you guys from Charlie Sawanka from Novak Electronics. Again, want to thank Charlie for appearing earlier in the show. Now, one of the tips that he mentioned was on a lot of the newer Novak speed controllers, they're including a cheat sheet so that you can go ahead and kind of follow along and program your speed controller on the fly and have everything at a glance. I've got a little twist on that, especially if you race in a lot of dirty areas, dusty areas, or if you not only use your transmitter with electric vehicles, but nitro vehicles. Instead of putting the little cheat sheet or the card on the bottom of your transmitter, pop your battery cover off, put it on the inside. What that'll do for you is it'll protect it from the elements. A lot of times, again, you may be in the dirt, you may be running a nitro vehicle as well, things that can kind of wear that sticker off. The other thing that does for you too is that you know exactly where it is, and you kind of have an unfair advantage from the competition because they can't just look down at your radio if they've got similar equipment. And make sure that you are properly prepared when you're going out and racing. And remember, proper preparation does prevent poor performance. Well, I do want to thank you all for watching us this week on the Horizon. There's a lot of news to cover this week, and there'll be even more news coming in the near future. Remember, iHobby is just around the corner, and we will have updates on our social networking pages like Google Plus and Facebook and Twitter that'll help bring you the experience of iHobby right to you. And if you are in the Cleveland, Ohio area, make sure you stop by and see us in the booth at iHobby 2012. John Redman will be there, I will be there as well, and we would absolutely love to see you. Stop by, say hi, and again, we'd love to see you there at iHobby 2012. Well, that will do it for us on this week's show. We will see you in 2 weeks just before iHobby, so we are sure to have a whole lot of cool gear. Now, take care and have some fun with hobbies.